So, I am Madhu Belur, I am in electrical engineering. So, let us start with using Linux tools. So, please note that using Linux tools is something that one will not just watch on the slides, you have to practice this hands on also. Not just using Linux tools, the entire workshop you have to simultaneously practice, without that it is not going to work. Yeah, please do not feel that here you just watch and during the week during assignments only you will start doing hands on, that will not work. So, for the same reason we have another computer connected here on which I will try hands on the various commands that we will start seeing in the slides. So, this is a quick outline of the various things we will cover today and tomorrow. So, FOSS has already been explained in detail. So, what is free about it? It is much more than just free, freely available tools, it is in fact also free for modification. The Linux itself has been inspired by Unix, but Unix was not open source, but Linux, the entire kernel, everything is available for also for viewing and for changing. So, there is a close link with something called GNU philosophy. So, there are plenty of libraries available in Linux for scientific computing. Important thing is can run forever. Yeah. So, this is extremely important because people are used to Windows and if you do not shut it down once a day or once in 2 days, it is going to hang. But Linux, people forget to shut off during weekends, meaning for the entire week it is running, during weekend also it is running, for another week, in other words it can run forever. Yeah. Of course, that is a sad thing nowadays with so much energy problems, one should learn to shut down the computer regularly. Okay, so we are going to be speaking about the shell. Yeah, so shell meaning shell, we will also use the word command prompt. So, the Linux command prompt and the Linux shell is what we will spend time on today and tomorrow, but of course, Linux also has a GUI, a graphical user interface, but that is what is anyway easy and very similar to Microsoft Windows, which everybody would have been familiar with. So, we are going to spend time on command line for this particular module. So, while it says control alt F1 indeed gives you a command line interface, what we are going to do is we are going to run all these commands inside a terminal. So, please open the terminal on all your Linux computers. So, how do you open terminal? If it is Ubuntu Linux, then you can press alt F2 and type gnome-terminal there. So, if you have difficulty opening the terminal, so this is a correct time for you to start the terminal now. Please start the terminal on your own computer. If you have difficulty, please ask the coordinator. We wait for 2 minutes for everybody, for all the 860 participants connected, to all have the terminal open now. The terminal will look something like this. Clear is the command to use for clearing the screen. So, what we are seeing here is what is called a command line interface, a shell, a terminal. So, is everybody having such a prompt, like we have a dollar here, where one can type various commands. Yeah, of course, this is not a right command, ls is one of the simplest command for seeing a list of all the files in that particular directory. Yeah. So, I hope everybody has opened a terminal on one's own computer. The terminal itself happens to be also available on Microsoft Windows, but then we are now emphasizing the terminal on the Linux for this particular module. So, once somebody has already opened the terminal, once somebody has opened the once somebody is on the command line terminal, one can ask which directory are we in. Yeah, so pwd stands for present working directory. Pwd is what, when you type pwd is a command, after pwd you can press the enter, because of which we have the output on the screen. It says that in this particular computer that I am working in, it is in something called home, Belur, desktop is a directory inside this Belur, and then the directory called test files. This is where we are currently in. If you want to see the list of files inside this directory, we can see that there are these three. These three are files or directories. So, incidentally, it is showing in blue color because these are directories. Yeah, one can go to another directory within this. This is what we can try now, CD 1, let us say 1 using Linux tools. Yeah, so, notice that I typed just 1 and then press the tab key. To press the tab key means it will try to auto complete, it will complete as long as there is no ambiguity. Yeah, so, 1 I pressed 1 and then I press the tab key, then it completed, because after pressing 1 there is only a unique completion. Yeah, rest all others, 1 starts with 2, 1 starts with 5. So, what is starting with 1? Only 1 underscore using Linux tools. So, we can press this and press enter. So, what we have done is we did CD meaning change directory to the directory name. So, we will say CD is a command, and whatever you typed after that command is an argument, CD argument. In this case, the argument is the name of the directory into which you want to go. So, why do not we do PWD now? So, we expect that now we are in home, Belur, desktop, test files, and also one using Linux tools. Yeah. So, this is indeed a very long present working directory because of the long names of the directories we have given. Well, let us see what is there now. There is something called examples. We could also navigate and go there. So, let us do that when that is indeed the next topic to see. So, in when these slides were made, when ls was typed there, these were the files that were visible. One could also see the files inside not just the current directory, but also a directory, one of the existing directories, that is also possible. So, please note in Linux like in Unix, all the commands, names of the files are all very much case sensitive. Yeah, unlike Windows, here capital or small does make a big difference. So, please note ls, all these ls is a command, all the commands are typically small letters unless they are contributed by somebody, and names of the directories, names of the files can of course be capital or small. We avoid spaces inside the name of the file or directory. If there are spaces, then what to do, we will see very soon, but we avoid it generally speaking. Now, how do you make a directory? Yeah. So, this is what we will see now. So, we were here last. So, let us go into examples. So, these are the various files here. Yeah. Why do not we make a new directory called test directory? Now, when we see, we have in addition to these files that were already there, we have something new that has got created called test directory. Further, notice that this test directory is blue. Yeah, what color it is, of course, depends on the terminal, it depends on Ubuntu, the operating system, it depends on what term we are using, whether colors have been enhanced. So, please do not become too much dependent on the fact that it is blue, that is why it is a directory. That is a minor detail that may not even be there available in all terminals. So, one can do ls minus l, ls long minus l, now we will say is an option for ls command. L is some option we want to give, and these options, that is why have a hyphen. Yeah. So, when we give ls minus l, I made the font slightly small for you to easily see. So, when you do ls minus l, then we see that we have all these dash here, because these are files, but precisely where we have test underscore directory, there in addition to it being blue, we also have d here. This d here stands, says that it is a directory. Yeah. Whether it comes in blue or not, at least this d will certainly be there. Yeah, because it is a directory. That part of the information that comes out will not change. Perhaps the blue color may be red color in some settings. Well, what about test? Yeah, one can say check what type of file is this test. Yeah, it says some ASCII text. what about test underscore directory? It says this is a directory. So, file is a command that one can use to check what type of file is this, is it a PDF file or is it a directory, is it a text file. This is also just some plain ASCII English text. Yeah. So, one can go to test underscore directory now and see what is there. Of course, this is a directory we created just now. So, quite understandably there is nothing inside it already. Yeah. We can go to one directory before cd space dot dot. This goes to the parent directory. So, dot, so please note dot means the current directory, double dot means the parent directory. After the command, after the command cd, always there will be a space. Yeah. If there is no space, then the command itself is different. So, command is cd here, after which you put a space and then dot dot, that goes to one directory before, so called parent directory. Again you can type this, you can go to one directory before again by cd space dot dot. Yeah. So, only now I am emphasizing that you have to put the space. Yeah, if there is no space, yeah, cd dot dot, if we do, let us see what happens, the command not found, it has included the dot dot into the name of the command. Yeah, you could type any some sort of expectedly meaningless command, and we do not expect such a command to exist. Yeah. So, notice that that entire name has come, after which the colon has come. Yeah, this is not a command it knows. Yeah, yeah, sorry, I had made the font smaller for a particular purpose. So, if you type something that is not an actual command, then it will say command not found. So, please learn to read very carefully what comes out. If it does not do what you intend it to do, it will give the error. From the error you please have to infer what has gone wrong. Yeah. So, cd dot cd, I said space dot dot, but if you do cd just dot dot, it is saying command not found. Yeah. Please note there is a space. Yeah. And now it has done what is required. Why? We can check present working directory and see, we can see that this one underscore using Linux tools into which we had gone some time instance before, it has gone back. We can go another. Yeah. So, this is how you will navigate through various directories, into various directories, into the previous directory, into the parent directory. Yes, we will call this as parent, these are all subdirectories. Subdirectories are like children. Yeah, you can go further deeper and deeper into the subdirectory. So, let us go back into test underscore files, and we had seen there are several directories here. Let us go to this other one. Yeah, this LaTeX is what we are supposed to learn next weekend, but then there is no harm in trying to see what is there inside. Yeah. So, here we have gone into the directories of another. Yeah. So, I can understand that these directories, these files are not already there on your computer. You can create your own directories, try to go into the directory, again try to go back into the parent directory. Let us go back to using Linux tools. Let us make another directory, another test. So, please note I am typing another underscore test. This particular key I have typed is called underscore. Yeah. So, why? Because we do not want to have spaces in the name of the file names. If you want, we can also put hyphen another dash test. Yeah. So, these are clearly two different directories, one with underscore, one with hyphen, one with dash. Yeah. So, now notice, let us use this tab again, CDA. So, it has completed up to another, then there is some ambiguity. One directory has this underscore, another directory has this dash, that is why it would not complete beyond that. So, if you type another tab, then it will tell you the two possible completions. Yeah, why? There has to be two or more completions, because of which that ambiguity was there and it has not completed. So, now you just type one letter to resolve that ambiguity and then press tab again, and it will indeed complete successfully now, because of no other ambiguities. So, let us go back to the slides. So, slides incidentally has an example where we have a space inside the name. Yeah, I told that we do not like these spaces, but in spite of that these slides are telling that there should be these spaces. Yeah, that is because you might often copy these directories, subdirectories from some Windows structure, and you already have these spaces inside, and we have to know how to deal with these spaces. Yeah, they may not be preferable, but they are they can easily occur for various reasons. So, let us see how to create a directory called software space engineering in two different ways. So, we are going to again go back to the command prompt, go back to the terminal and type which command? Make directory software engineering with space in the middle. Yeah. Instead of space, notice that there is also this slash, yeah, backslash, I believe. Also, if you do not want the slash, you can put it in double quotes. These are the two things we will type and see. So, please notice that there is this escaped word here. Yeah. So, this backslash we will like to say is an escape character. The space is an important thing, that is what we will see now. And if you want the space to come in literally, then you have to escape it using a backslash. So, make directory. After the command, as I said, there has to already be a space. Yeah, make directory, new directory. If we type like this, what will it do? It has created two different directories called new and directory. Did you intend like that? You intended one directory with the name new directory. Yeah, and we didn't put hyphen in the middle, we didn't put underscore in the middle. Because of all this, if you put a space, it is like another argument to the command make dir. If yeah, we have given two arguments, and for make dir, it thought that you want to make two directories. Two directory names are being given. One directory name that you want is new, another directory name you want is dir. You can also do ls minus l if you think that it has just interchanged the order. That is not the case, it has created two different directories. CLEAR, clear, is the name for clearing the screen. Yeah, very soon we will try to spend some time on some shortcuts for these. So, ls minus l will tell you that there are two directories, d and n. Yeah, I think typically these are alphabetical, that is why d has come up. So, how do we actually make a directory called new underscore directory? Just type new underscore directory, but new space directory if you want now, and you do not want to create two new directories. Well, why do not we see what happens? You say these are already existing. Yeah, the new, sorry, thank you. If we type again, it says that we cannot create it. Why? Because it is already there. Yeah, what is already there? It says file already exists. Yeah, I think in this Linux, Unix operating system, file and directory are more or less the same. Yeah. So, for that reason, it says it already exists. Why do not we do make dir new backslash? Yeah. Now, when we do, it will take the space as literally. So, now it has indeed created. It has created a new directory called new directory. Yeah, as was written there, we can also put it in double quotes. If we started with double quotes, we'll put it in double quotes. So, software engineering is now one directory, there is a space inside. If you want to go into that soft, then we can press the tab, it will go. Yeah, and when it is going, it is showing us that it has escaped the space, it has escaped the space using that backslash. Yeah, of course, there is nothing in there. So, let us go back to the slides. So, please note, generally we use hyphens and underscores instead of spaces in the names. For this reason, because we have to escape it. Also, when we see a list of all the files, in the list that is visible, the space will not be there, but you have to use a space, the slash will not be there, but you need the slash when you are moving into directories. So for shell scripts, it's going to be a little problem. For those reasons, we just avoid using the space. So we have already seen how to go to various directories, how to see the present working directory. It says you can also do cd space dot slash cs, yeah. So cs. So you see that our slides all have cs as the name of the course. That is because C stands for software engineering for engineers and scientists. Yeah, I am digressing from this using Linux tools for a minute. We see the C's again in the various directories, various names of the modules. That is because C's was indeed the name of the course we had kept for this particular course. When we tried to introduce this course in IIT curriculum, that is the course that is running now. The one semester will finish now, in another 2 weeks the semester will finish. But when we were introducing this course, that time the course was recommended the name software development techniques. Yeah, so I am in electrical engineering department, Prabhu is in aerospace. We were not aware that software engineering happens to be some important term in computer science literature. There software engineering refers to perhaps, yeah, those participants of you who are from computer science engineering departments are would already know software engineering is an existing term, and our course is actually about software development techniques for engineers and scientists. So the new course is SDES. So we'll change all the slides, but anyway, if it's only name of a directory, it doesn't matter. So C's is the name of the directory as far as the slide is concerned. So we want to go into the C's directory. So you see that there is only one single dot here. Yeah, I already told what is double dot. Double dot stands for parent directory that we see here. Yeah, cd space dot dot goes to the previous directory, but just dot itself is also often required. We want to have a way of specifying the current directory, the present directory. So dot alone stands for the present directory. So sometimes you may not have to explicitly use this dot. Yeah, here it says alternatively you can say cd space dot slash c's. Yeah, so you can use cd space dot slash c's. Dot stands for current directory. From the current directory you want to go to c's, there dot may not be required. Yeah, so let us see what happens. So we'll make, okay, where are, what's the present working directory? Some really long name. Why don't we go back? We went to, let's go back one more. Yeah, so this is our present working directory, relatively short now. Let's make another. Let's call this D1, D2, D3 from now on. Otherwise, all these paths are becoming long. Yeah, so let's call this DIR1. So numbers are very much possible. So let's see what's there now. Let's DIR1 also. Let's go to DIR1. Let's make two directories now. DIR2, DIR3. Yeah, these are two separate directories. So when you want to give an option, then the hyphen is very much important. Yeah. So when you use on your own computers, so you don't have to make the fonts larger and smaller the way I'm doing. I'm doing the font smaller only when we want everything to come on the same line. So we have this two directories, DIR2 and DIR3. So suppose we want to go to, yeah, this is one way we already saw, yeah. But we could also specify that from the current directory we want to go to DIR2. Yeah, the meaning of this is cd dot slash. Dot slash means from the current directory you are specifying the further path from here. So we are here now. Yeah, so we could also so please note that this dot is important. You cannot say cd slash dir something. This slash refers to the earliest. Yeah, so please take careful note of what is being done now. We are currently in present working directory, whatever is on the screen. If you do cd slash this goes to PWD now is just slash. Is this called the root directory? Harish, root. Just slash is a root directory. Yeah, so we are not, we don't want our directory 2, directory 1 that we created is not here. And anyway, let's see what's there here. This is what you can see on your own computers. We cannot make, most likely we can't make a new directory here. Yeah, therefore, it says, look, you can have permissions to create various directories, various files inside your home directory. You cannot go to the root directory where the super user is supposed to have the permission only. Only the super user is supposed to have the permission. Yeah. So it says permission denied. Permission has been denied to us because we are only a simple user, not the super user, not the root. So why don't we just go back to where we were, and try to create our directories over there, not ambitiously created in the root directory. So how do we go back to where we were? Are we going to type the long path? Yeah. So there are, we will see in more detail tomorrow some shell variables. So why don't we just go to the old present working directory? Yeah. So in just one shot, we went to where we were. Yeah. You each one of you can go back to where you were by using the long path. There, incidentally, there is some particular environment variable called old PWD. Yeah. If you change your directory, then automatically this present working directory and old present working directory variables are having this information. Yeah, if you are very lazy, don't want to type long, then you can keep track of these variables and just go back there suddenly. Yeah. So these shell variables are seen by using the dollar prompt. Please don't feel that these are some things that is outside the course. Very soon, tomorrow is when we will see these shell variables in more detail. As far as I am concerned, we just went back to this directory now. Yeah. So we were seeing whether to specify the full path. Yeah. So we are here now. We can go from here to dir 1. Again, dir. When we press the tab, there are these two completions. Let's say dir 3. Yeah. Whenever you press tab, and if it's the name of a directory, when you press tab, it will end with the slash. Slash means it's a directory. That is why you have room for going further. It's a directory, so you can go there and see what's there. Of course, these are directories we created some time ago. There are no files there. So let us see how to just create a new file. How to edit this file? That's the next thing we might see. So touch command, yeah, creates a blank file. So we have been creating these directories. There are no files. The only files we saw were already there in my computer. Perhaps you want these files also. While these files are already kept on Moodle, you might want to just create this file. So how do we create this new file? Yeah, are we going to open office or some big editor for just creating a blank file? Are we going to do that? No, touch is a very useful command for that purpose. So please see the various commands on the screen while we try these commands here and create some new file. Yeah. So please note here we have inside this particular directory 3, dir 3. We don't have any files. That is why we do ls minus l. We'll say, look, there's nothing. Yeah. So please note, just ls al. After all, in the current directory, what is certainly there is the current directory itself. Also, there is a possibility of going to the previous directory. Why don't we do ls minus al? Ls minus a. It says show really all. A for all, I think. It says that look, there is this dot directory and ... that possibility is there. These are the two directories, but more generally there might be some file names that start with dot. Yeah, these are ones that we are not really interested in editing again. For example, in your own terminal, in your home directory, there will be one .bashrc most likely. Yeah, because that is the script that starts default nowadays, bash. That is the one that we will teach in detail. So .bashrc perhaps will be there, not here, not in this deep subdirectory, but inside the home directory. So why don't we create that particular file now? So we'll touch file 1, file 2, dot file 3. Just for the sake of explanation, file 4 dot txt, file 5 dot pdf. Why don't we create a empty pdf file? Please note, we are creating empty files with different names. Some of them are starting with dot, some of them are having extension, some of them are not having extension. Some extensions are ridiculous. Empty files. File, nobody prevents us from creating file 6 dot doc. Luckily Microsoft has not patented the doc extension name already. We can just create this empty one. Lo, we have so many files suddenly. We had created dot file 3 also, that is not here. All other files are here. Some cheating is going on here. Dot file 3, did it not get created, or did it get created but it is not visible here? So why don't we do ls minus a and see, look here, dot file 3 is visible. The purpose of this exercise is all file names that start with dot, in other words they have only an extension. Of course dot file 3 is not an extension, but it starts with dot, those are not visible generally. I think hidden, to say that hidden is too much, but they will be visible if you use the A option. Ls minus A will show them to you. There are all these txt files, pdf files, file 1, file 2, what do they have inside them? We have not yet seen how to see inside a file. Inside this pdf file, how to view them? Do we need acrobat reader? Is it really a pdf file? It is all an empty file. The same command touch created all these files, these are all empty files. Why don't we see ls minus l, ls minus l, has is showing us all these files. There is this particular column. This column being 0 means that the size of this file is 0, whether it is 0 bytes or 0 kilobytes or 0 megabytes. How to make that information come in a very useful form, we will see later, but if it is 0, then it is 0 megabyte, 0 kilobyte, 0 byte, 0 bit. It is an empty file. What type of file is it? Just because it is a PDF file, does it really have a PDF content? Why don't we see file? File is also a command. So the way we are using it here, let me increase the font size again. File, the first thing we type in the prompt is the command, then there is always a space, there may or may not be an option, and after that there is an argument. File as a command requires an argument. You cannot type just file. Says, look, the usage of this file command is requires this option, and then you are supposed to say the file. Sorry, I use my hand. See what, just type file on each of your terminal. We want to get used to being told something is incorrect. We all the participants should learn to type commands wrongly, should learn to see what is written on the screen, learn to infer oneself what is gone wrong. We are very much available for help, but then at the end of this course you all want to reach a stage where you can help yourselves. So we want to teach you to do that also. So please type this command file, just file, no argument, no option also. If you do that, this bash terminal is very polite. It is not saying that you guys are typing things wrongly intentionally. It is saying, look, this is the usage. Usage, file, usage, this is how you are supposed to use, command, square brackets, square bracket. Please note, square, inside the square bracket there are some dash. How do you understand this? Whatever is in square bracket is like optional, you may or may not want to type all that. the command will work even if you don't type that. Yeah, so that is why it is in square bracket. If you want to type an option B, then type file minus B, file space minus B, then there might be some other options. Yeah, these options, for example, minus E. If you type minus E, minus E option requires a argument. Yeah, just that option minus E itself might require a argument. Minus F itself might require an argument. At the end of this, finally, there is this file. Yeah, I mean the file command cannot proceed without the main argument. That is why it has given this error. It has not told us quite politely. It has not told us that there is an error. It is telling us this is the usage. If you want more help, file minus minus. My keyboard is typing extra characters. So file minus. If you type. See why I am emphasizing file command. Incidentally, file I believe is an extremely important command, but is not listed in the slides. We will certainly try our best to include this in the slides, but this is something you can take note of. Meanwhile, file minus minus help will give you details of all this various options. Yeah, when we type just file, it just told us this is the usage. All these different options, what are they supposed to be used for? Who will tell us that? File minus minus help will give us the detailed information. Yeah, there are different ways to get this information. Currently the usage is file minus minus help. There is also a man page. Perhaps there is also help file. Help file. Yeah, there is no help topic. There are different ways of this help information being organized. There is also man file. Yeah. So this man is another. So I am typing this very fast, but very soon we will cover all this in the slides. Yeah, so man is something called manual, man for manual, I think. Man file will give you a detailed manual, Q for exiting out of this man, out of the man page. If you want to exit and come back to the prompt, Q for quit. So we were in the process of creating various files, creating various empty files using the touch command. We already noted that one particular file is missing, which we can see by typing like this. Is this the right way to type? Is this the right way to type the option minus A? Let's see. It says command not found. Yeah, it is taking ls minus A all together as the command. As I said, ls itself is a command, and a space had better be there. Why? Because minus A is an option. The syntax is command space option space argument. You can also give an argument, file 1. Yeah, it says, yeah, just if that file 1 were a directory, yeah, make directory dir 4. So here we have these. You can do ls dir 3 dir 4. This is what was there in the slides before. Directly list the files that are there in dir 4. Of course, there is nothing. At least there is nothing that does not start with dot. Ls minus a dir. Inside dir 4, there is actually a dot and a double dot. These two will always be there. There might also be some, yeah, let us see this. Ls minus a when you do. So it has again shown us this dot. This dot it has shown, that is nothing but the current directory I told. This double dot, that stands for the parent directory, the previous directory. There is this dir 4 that we have created just now. Please don't bank on it being red on blue color, because it is a directory and different terminals may show it in different colors. Yeah, all these are of course files. This dot file 3 was the one that was not shown unless you put the dot, unless you show the minus a option. Ls minus a l when we do, then it is showing us all these directories. Of course, have some size on the hard disk, some 4096 bits or bytes or kilobytes, I have never understood, but do not worry about it. It is a small number in any case. In these days of large disk sizes, no need to worry about it. So dot file here is visible, and therefore importantly has this d at the start. Rest all to note is all these are 0. After having noted that they are 0, we want to now see what type of file are these. So why don't we see file 1, it says empty file. We were seeing the usage of the command file for this purpose. All these empty files we have created, what type of file is it? File 5.pdf. File 5 we press and press the tab key. There is only one way it can be extended, can be completed, file 5.pdf. Just because you gave it the extension pdf does not make it a pdf file, it still is an empty file. You might cheat the user by giving different extension names, but the operating system has not got cheated. The file command itself is very much able to see what that file is. So let me copy a example. Let me copy a file here. So cp for copy, we have not yet seen that particular command. So I have copied some other file in my particular computer, I know it is somewhere else. I am copying that file to the current directory. So how does this cp command work? Cp ls mv cd, cp for copy, mv for move. We will see this very soon, please do not take notes, it is not required, the slides have all this information, just that I find that right now is the correct time to say it, that is why I am saying it. So cp is a command for copying a file from somewhere, from a source to a destination place, and in the destination to specify that, it is very helpful to have the dot. Cp command we will see in very much, we will see in much more detail. So before we go further, before we also stop for tea, this is a good time to stop for doubts. So while I strongly encourage you all to also interrupt me for asking doubts, this is a place where we will stop, ask various doubts. Please do not ask doubts about cp, because cp we are anyway going to cover in detail, we will clear doubts about that as we go on. So please ask your doubts one by one now. So please ask your doubts. You can contact the coordinator to initiate the button there, so that we are able to know from here who wants to ask the doubt, and we will connect to that person. You can also ask your doubts on chat. If you have doubts, in the users list there is a hand raise button. Under the users list there is a hand raise button, please press that button, and then immediately here we are able to see that there is a doubt from so and so place, and we immediately connect. Please ask. We are connected to Udaipur now, please ask your doubt, we are able to hear you, I think.
So my question is that when we are writing a command like ls hyphen al, then the first thing we are getting is a total. So total number of changes. So what those number are, because whenever we are making a new directory, this number are changes by 4.
Thank you for the question. We in IIT Bombay could hear the question. Let me repeat the question so that all others can hear it in case they have not heard it. So the question was that when you create a new directory, you go to the directory and type ls, and then there is some total coming. So total comes on the top. If there are other things in the directory, then of course there will be many other things also visible, but what does this total mean? Perhaps this, let us try this. The total perhaps means the total number of files and directories inside that. And if it is 0, if there is nothing there, if you make a new directory, there is nothing yet there, so then it will come as 0. So why do not we type here ls, ls minus l will have that extra information. So please note, so here we have this, the question was what is this total. So total, why do not we created this directory dir 4, let us see inside dir 4 what is that total. Here it is 0, while here when we did, it had 4 things, Is 4 the total, is that 4 the total number of things, number of files excluding directories? Yeah. So my friends here who know about this and I don't know about this, I didn't know so far. It turns out that 4 number stands for the total number of files. Yeah, but the file number of files is 5 here. Yeah. 1 stands, so this 1 stands says it's a file, I think. This 2 says that it's a directory. Number of links 2, so to say this is 4, and this 2 stands for, you come back from this from within the directory and from here, that's why it's 2. I thank you for this question. I don't know this answer, and after using Linux for 15 years, I don't know the answer. So most likely it's not important for further usage. Yeah, but then if somebody of you can find this out and tell us, we all will benefit from this. That is the best I can say, because we should go to other questions which are likely to be of more use to everybody. Yeah. Okay. So the next question is from Kakinada.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
I would like to ask one question. You told that you can create any file with an extension of anything. So I want to create an extension of file name by .bat.
Yeah.
That is something like a batch file, which you are doing in a DOS operating system. So can you create a same kind of file in Unix operating system also?
This is a good question. See, we are at a stage where we are just creating new files using the touch command, and I put PDF and TXT as an example just to say that you can create any file with any extension. Yeah, and the Linux operating system, the way it works, does not really depend on the extension you give. And if it is a batch file, in DOS we have .bat extension, and that that is like a shell script. In bash we will give sh extension. When we come to that, we will certainly cover this in more detail, but the batch file itself will not run here the way it runs in MS-DOS, simply because it was all DOS commands there. Here we have Linux commands. So but then nobody will prevent us from naming a file as file.bat. So we will stop for tea now. Please post your questions on chat, and we will certainly also take up the questions live on audio. But then if you have typed it on chat, we can take them up first. Yeah, thank you very much. We meet in 20 minutes. Thank you.